Today we take feet literally in hands, in our skillful hands, which will transform a thick woolen clothes piece in comfortable, all-cut-out house slippers. To begin with, we will master simple assemblage and will make paper patterns. And then, by means of a double-sided tape and a pick, which we will make of an insole with a loose leaf, we will get the exact pattern for tight fitting sock from a thick woolen clothes. If there are boots stockings, why not to be a sock boot? All is in our hands. Hello, dear viewers. It is said that the man who is in a bad mood got out of bed on the wrong side. Therefore, to get out of bed on the correct right foot, it's necessary to take feet in hands, and it turns out it's in our hands. Today we turn into the history of fashion, and in particular to history of shoe craft, we'll try to apply all finds of our ancestors to ourselves in our house purposes. It appears very simple and accessible. And the very first variant is the variant of all cut-out footwear, which we have peeped at very interesting leather masters, who didn't cut the pattern, but made all of one piece of leather. Now I will show how to make the simplest pattern. Look attentively at my hands and all will be clear to you. So, we outline the insole, which is convenient to us. Now we repeat on a paper a contour of the top part to an input in our slipper. I move apart just circled contour to the necessary number of centimeters. You need to consider the height. In other words, in step, and the top detail should be expanded on such number of centimeters what is your end step. Further, you need to fix this detail nearby on the pattern. I have a rectangle in height of 3 cm. Now we will cut such strange detail and after we'll pin to look what model we've got.
Соберем его сначала булавочками, чтобы посмотреть, какой у нас получился макет.
All is very simple. Here is a 3 cm strip, and we have the insole detail. As you see, I have made a tuck from behind. It's very simple to make. You enter here a foot, raise this part and to begin with make such fold. Here such fold. and then consider a thrust of the stock and cut just enough so that the shoes are set on your foot. You saw that we don't have allowance for seams. We connected all seams end to end, therefore we cut out the detail without an allowance. And now we have stitch from the wrong side. Connecting end to end a thick woolen cloth, a single seam, at first from this side, then have turned and have repeated operation in the field of attack behind. Now it's necessary to turn out thus at the front side. And you see that considering a thickness of a fabric, here we have the crack. We need to sew it up also. The needle goes thus, in parallel, without passing inside, but sliding on the fabric surface, laying the same stitches. And here in this part later we will camouflage with a pin pile and will get all cutting out slipper, in which it's necessary to enclose our felt and sole and to finish work. We start. And by the way, very important technological moment. I'm often asked why there are so many scissors on the table. Really, scissors have the appointment. The scissors that cut paper, in no event it's impossible to cut the fabric and vice versa. They become useless. We have mastered the first variant and now we'll try to simplify all. You think that it's impossible? Pay attention to how interesting the shoemakers work using various boot trees. Today, boot tree is plastic, in the ancient time was wooden. We will try to think up from household subjects the simplest boot tree which will render you the feasible help. I want to pay your attention to the technological process both at medieval and at the modern master is still made in a very similar manner. Look, it's a medieval workshop in which for each client was made the boot tree. It were wooden boot trees and then on them sewed footwear. Modern master works in a similar way, but in his hands more economic methods, maybe more quick glues, more interesting joint materials, but the work principle is similar. And I have thought, if you don't have master who can make the boot trees, it can be made very simply. How? I took a usual felt and sole. Today in footwear sometimes put such. They happen different, for example, plastic loose leaves. That my pig had an instep, I have made foot thus. And between and above I have filled with rags. And after, having put on a stocking or any sock woolen or knitted, you simply provide fixing of all these components. You have such convenient pig. On it you can felt shoes, can model on it not to disturb endlessly your own legs. And it's very convenient. Now I will show you how quickly to make a pattern for all cutting out slipper. There are boot stockings and we will have such slipper stocking which will densely fit a foot and we will make it literally in a few minutes. You won't believe, but all will be very simple. I took a usual old sock. Even if it's not so new, you just need its fixing basis. You put on a sock, then take a double-sided tape and fix on the sock layers directly on the pig this adhesive tape. Further, you take one more sock. If it's big and you can pull it gradually together with escalating of layers of an adhesive tape, you take a sock. If a sock isn't so big and not to disturb an adhesive tape, you simply cut the sock and gradually fix it directly on the gluing basis. You have three layers. The first is the one sock, the second an adhesive tape, the third the second textile basis. It can be not only a sock but also any fabric. But the most important thing that after you take scissors and cut everything that you got on the center line, you have volume pattern. This is a mold of your foot. You spread it on a level surface and make cuts which will be tacks. You need to transform the volume form in absolutely flat. In other words, the volume model needs to be made flat. It will be a pattern of your model. I will pay attention to a small detail. Look, I have cut out not two details, but one all cut out. If to combine them thus in the center, there is such tag. It's possible to cut it out and then here there will be also a seam, but you can't to cut it. Then, at boot assemblage, you will need to leave behind a crack, either for a lighting or for a fastener. Then the foot very densely will enter into the shoe, it will be comfortable to it, but in this place there will be some weak point, because that the model tightly fit a foot, it's necessary to cut out a tag and to stitch end to end. Pay attention to the seam with which we have connected details. It allows to get almost all cutting out form of shoes. You saw at first I worked from the wrong side, then the same seam I have passed on the upper side, and as a result we get absolutely seamless product. The most important thing that the foot won't experience any discomfort, as there will be no connecting seams which usually disturb. And one more thing. In the center, as I cut out the tag, you also can connect it with bayonet seam and leave a cut. And this cut can be left and behind as we already spoke. Then it will be necessary to join all tag entirely. We need only to try on and admire the result of our hands. Sociologists assert that the weather in the house very often depends on the small factor, shambling work of members of household. It turns out these very annoying relatives. Therefore, in such footwear, I'm sure, the climate and atmosphere of your house will be ideal. The master class is finished. Why I have unexpectedly remembered one son? I stare after her, there is nothing in her, but I'm still looking and don't remove my eyes. I'm simply sure that your house footwear, which you will make according to our advices, will be such. There is nothing but it's impossible to take away an eye. Good luck to new meetings. With you today there was Tatiana Lazareva.